unto repentance, seeing they crucified to themselves the Son of God afresh, and put him to an open shame.
My Lord.
I'm sorry, but that couldn't be me.
Jesus.
That couldn't be me. Like, I know God is real. I know he's real for myself. Like, my brother's going to test, and sister's going to test. Like, I try to elaborate and explain how the Holy Ghost is to those who aren't professing the Holy Ghost.
Mm.
And I always find it kind of hard. But I want, like, the only way I can explain it is as real as I know if I open my mouth, words are going to come
hey.
Out.
Amen. Amen.
It's as real as if I wake up in the morning, I know I'm going to be able to see my wife. Mm.
Jesus.
It's as real as on Friday I will get paid.
Where is that?
Like, that's the only way. He's as real as me snapping my fingers right now.
Uh-huh. Know it.
We're going to continue to read and have taste of the good word of God and the powers of the world to come. If they shall fall away, to renew them to again unto repentance, seeing they crucified to themselves the Son of God afresh, and put him to an open shame. But the earth which drinketh in the rain that cometh off upon it, and bringeth forth herbs meet for them by whom it is addressed, receiveth blessings from God. But that which beareth thorns and briers is rejected, and is nigh unto cursing, whose end is to be burned. We don't want to continue in this mediocre style of doctrine.
My Lord.
We don't want to be stagnant in our walk with Christ.
My Lord.
Yes, I profess the Holy Ghost, but I also want to be obedient.
Amen. That's right, brother.
If God is led by the Spirit, ask me to do something, I'm going to do it.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I want to be led by the Spirit always. I don't want to be stagnant here. Clapping my hands every day, not receiving nothing on the Sunday.
I'm
sorry.
That's right.
What fruits am I bearing? What fruits am I giving for?
Amen.
What am I doing for my family? What am I doing for my wife?
Amen.
I don't want to be stagnant. But beloved, we are persuaded better things of you, and things that accompany salvation, though we thus speak. But God is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which ye have shown towards his name, and that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister. And we desire that every one of you do show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope unto the end, that ye be not slothful, but followers of them who do through faith and patience inherit the promises.
You Lord.
For when God made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swear by himself.
You Jesus.
Saying, surely blessing, I will bless thee, and multiplying, I will multiply thee. And so, after he had plenty endured, he obtained the promise. So Abraham was obedient.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
He waited patiently.
Yes, he did.
And he obtained the promise. So if I wait patiently, I adhere to the Spirit.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Thank you. What's my predestinated goal? What's my predestinated path?
Where is it?
Jesus. So it's that simple. So God gives us a plan.
Yes.
The plan of salvation. Lays it on down the line. All we gotta do is sit.
Come on.
Read, follow, and
right.
Obey.
Amen.
And then we made it. Is that too hard? Lord, thank you. For men barely swear by the greater, and an oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife. Wherein God willing me more abundantly to show unto the promise the immutability of his counsel, confirmed by an oath. That by two immutable things in which it was possible for God to lie, we might have a strong consolation who have fled for refuge to lay hold upon the hope set before us. Which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, which enter into that within the veil. I just want to be ready.
Yes.
I just want to be ready.
Amen, brother. Amen.
It's impossible to have a solid or believe you have a solid foundation in Christ. Fall away from it and build another solid foundation. How was your foundation solid to begin with?
That's right.
There's no way you can't grandfather your way into the heaven.
Amen.
Just because you have the Holy Ghost for some more years, that don't guarantee you a spot.
That's right. Amen.
Like I professed the Holy Ghost in 2013. And I would say I was tearing on my life. Like all I knew was church, and till this day, that's all I know. Like I worked, I went to school, but that's all I knew. But I was always frustrated and just striving to receive it because I not yet understood it. So I'm waiting. I was always waiting. I was like, God, why won't you fill me? Why won't you fill me? Send your power, Lord. Send it down to me. But then I started to realize, like, as I got older and as I started to get more into my word, that the Holy Ghost is already here.
That's right. Thank you, Lord.
But it was just up to me to accept it.
Amen. Amen.
I didn't quite understand it.
Wow.
So like, all this time, like, I've been waiting for you to just touch me. I felt that you just weren't going to pick me for some reason. The Holy Ghost is staring me dead in my face. Waiting for me to understand it. And I can allow it in. So I attend the concert with my wife. She can remember it. We go to the church without all of Donnie Clark in Long Island. And he Donnie Clark is up there. He's preaching a sermon. I don't remember it. I testified about it many times.
It's all right.
And it was a sermon that my dad preached all the time, laying aside every weight. And I heard my dad preaching a lot. And then just the way he said it with conviction. But he said it, then I grabbed that understanding that the Holy Ghost was just right there. I was just dwelling on my understanding, just reading through his word, that the Holy Ghost is just right here. And I allowed him in. And he took over my tongue.
Hey!
Hallelujah!
Jesus!
And I cannot forget that day. I'll never forget that day. And I'm sorry. And now I'm going off topic. But I can't, like, myself. Sorry, I'm going to sound real cocky. My foundation is solid.
Thank you, Lord.
I can't turn away. There's no choice for me to turn away because I don't know anything else.
Yes. Yes.
He owes me nothing. Hallelujah. But I thank you for everything. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
God is real. I'm sorry.
Yes, he is.
He's real if you don't believe me.
Yes, he is.
If you have a little bit of doubt, I'm sorry. But I'm telling you, he is real.
Amen.
Yes, he is.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. For those who are seeking, I'm not going to call an altar call. I'm sorry. It's led by someone else to do it. It's so big. I'm not going to call an altar call. But those who truly want to be saved, just Just think about his love.
Mm.
Just think about just you being here. Just think about how you're breathing right now.
That's right. Amen. What he's done.
How can you not understand that? The way you're breathing, the way you're opening your eyes and blinking.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen.
I'm telling you, it's that real. And I wish I could explain it more, but hallelujah. I wish I could save you all. Right now, I'm trying to worry about myself. I'm trying to be ready.
Amen.
I'm trying to be battle ready.
Thank you, Lord.
And I do want to say this for those who are doubtful, those who have been and profess the Holy Ghost and are on shaky ground, you really need to check yourself.
Yes.
It's impossible to be truly enlightened by God and then lose faith. I'm sorry.
Amen.
There's no way. You are on shaky ground.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
The Lord put his plan down there. And it's called the plan of salvation. Will you accept it? Pray for me, Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord.
The word of the Lord tonight was powerful.
Yes, yes, it was.
But what happens is we not let the word of God take root in our hearts. And oftentimes people are preaching the word of God and delivering the word of God to us, and sometimes we're not listening. We're not listening. And here's why I know we're not listening. It's because Brother Daniel has ministered some things tonight that I've spoken in this house and he was nowhere to be found.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So some of y'all still quiet.
Mm-hmm.
When word like that comes as confirmation of God,
that's right.
It's impossible to sit there.
Amen.
And not respond to God.
Amen.
For his word.
Amen.
Are you watching? From the conversation we just had last night.
Yes, yes.
Yes, Jesus.
See, this is how God does. God will lead you to bring somebody who doesn't hold a title in the church, who is not an ordained minister or preacher of the gospel, but whom he would put his spirit in, who he would deal with, to come and to reveal his heart to his people. And what happens is we take it for granted. God is speaking to his people. This brother said some things that the Holy Ghost dealt with me concerning you in the pews today. Because I had a conversation, a 3-hour conversation last night with two individuals in this building who could attest to that many things that he just stated I just said to y'all last night.
Amen. Amen.
Just said to y'all last night. And he was nowhere in the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Nowhere to be found. So it lets us know that God is trying to get your attention.
Yes. Amen.
Let's know that God is trying to get your attention. But how are we going to respond to God when God speaks to us and is trying to give us what is needed to go higher in hell? The Holy Ghost spoke to me today and said, to tell the people that I will only meet you where you come. The reason, Brother Jeffrey, we do not see healing and deliverance and the power of God in the church, because you refuse to go to where God is.
Mm.
God says, I'm not coming down to where you are. You got to come to where I am.
Amen. Amen.
Until we as God's people who profess to have the Holy Ghost will come to where he is, we will not see him manifest.
Amen.
And we will not see him revealed. Until we come to where he is. God spoke clearly to me and said, tell them to meet me somewhere in the spirit.
Mm.
And wherever they go, I will meet them there.
Amen.
I will meet them there. Oftentimes what we're doing is we're waiting for God. But in fact, it's God that is waiting for us.
Amen. Amen.
I don't know when the church is going to wake up to the reality that God is not going to do more than what we do.
Mm-hmm.
And what we give. And where we go in the spirit. Brother Daniel stated something that I know for a fact he was not here to hear. Neither could he sit at home and listen to it on YouTube or Facebook, because I purposely had a service after the service with the saints one Sunday, and it was not recorded or documented anywhere. And verbatim, he said the words that I have not yet said publicly, but he said it publicly today.
Mm.
Some of y'all are waiting for the Holy Ghost to be poured out, and you're waiting for God to send you the Holy Ghost, and the Holy Ghost is already here.
Already here. Amen.
And so now you're waiting for something that has already been given, and all you got to do is receive it. Folks get to this altar and they're praying, God, fill me with the Holy Ghost. God, give me the Holy Ghost. He already gave it.
That's right. Amen.
Amen.
What do you think Acts 2 was all about? When the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were in one place with one accord, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind, filled all the house where they were sitting, appeared to them with cloven tongues of fire, set upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. So God pours it out. When he pours it out, it didn't go back up.
Amen.
Amen.
To go wait to be poured out again.
Mm-mm.
And then go back up.
Nope.
Wait to be poured out again. When he poured out the Holy Ghost, he poured out the Holy Ghost for everybody that will receive.
Amen. Amen.
And all you got to do today is receive them.
Amen.
And then some of you that have them, you got to walk in him.
Mm-hmm.
It's not good enough to just have him. But you got to walk in him. Let him operate in you.
Amen.
Let him move in you. Let him speak through you.
Amen.
Let him totally consume you.
Take over you.
That's Lord. Jesus.
With no reservation.
Mm.
With no hesitation.
Mm.
With no restrictions, with no limitations. And here's why. Because you've not received the spirit of bondage. You receive a spirit that liberated you.
That's right. Jesus.
Something else, Brother Daniel, tapped on and touched on that the Holy Ghost spoke to me as I was consulting the Lord about the ministry here and about you that sit in the pews trying to figure out what the condition is and what the problem is and why it seems that people sit here after being filled with the Holy Ghost and are not at liberty to praise the Lord.
Amen. My Lord.
They're worshiping with condemnation. Condemnation is when you do something or say something, and that's the only thing that eats at you. You watch something wrong, or you had the wrong conversation, or you did something, you made a mistake, you failed, and you committed sin on Saturday night, and so when you come into the house of God, you
amen. Amen.
By whatever the shortcoming has been. And then what you allow the enemy to do is you allow the enemy to say, well, you're not worthy to lift your hands. And you're not worthy to open up your mouth. You're not worthy to sing a song of praise to God. You're not worthy to dance before the Lord. Uh-huh. And so you sit there and you wallow in condemnation. But the Bible says there is therefore now no
condemnation.
Lift up your hands.
Yes.
Y'all didn't hear what I said. I said lift up your hands.